You know, I know what Scripture tells me about sharing my faith. I know that God doesn't place a lot of responsibility on me making this thing happen, because it's only God that saves people to start with. You know, that ought to take so much pressure off of me. Because God says in His Word, in John, no one comes to the Father unless the Spirit draws him. It also tells me in 1 Corinthians, I might be the one that plants the seed, and I may get to be the one that waters the seed, but it's only God who makes it grow. So really, it's just my privilege to be there and watch it happen. But I tell you what, I tell my teenagers this a lot. You can say what you think, but you will live what you believe. And what happens is, I'm amazingly bold when it doesn't matter. And I know all the answers right up here, but when it's time and it's me and my friend, you know what starts popping in my head? Things that aren't in Scripture. Fear that's not from God. Questions like, what if I mess this up? I mean, what if he has questions that I don't know the answers to? And a lot of times, especially when my friend's going through a storm in their life, God, what in the world am I supposed to say to make this all better? When I was first starting in student ministry, my co-youth pastor is actually here tonight. His name is Reagan Ferris. He was actually a kid in my youth group because I am old. And I was going to college in Graceville, about 45 minutes away from the church, and I remember getting a call at the church saying, you got to come home. And I remember Reagan telling me that his friend Stephen's dad was killed on the job that day. Freak accident at work. Was electrocuted. And that just shook our town. And it shook my students. And I remember racing there on this 45-minute drive home, wondering, what in the world am I going to say? As though all the weight was on me, right? And I finally got to the guys, and I remember sitting with the guys and asked them, how many of you guys have you talked to Stephen yet? How's he doing? And I remember one of them saying, we hadn't talked to him yet. I remember one of the guys looking at me and saying, Mark, what are we supposed to say? I mean, I don't even know why this had to happen. Now, I'm supposed to go and be super Christian guy and give all the right verses and make everything better. He goes, I don't know how to do that. I remember sitting and praying with some of these fellas. I remember God just kind of meeting with us. And after praying, I remember saying to him, guys, you know, I've been feeling the same way. But I don't think it's our job today to have all the answers. I think what we're supposed to do is just go love on Stephen. Tell him we love him. Tell him we're sorry. Just love him like Jesus would. I'll never forget the last night. Melanie and I were pulling into the funeral home, and it was that usual scene, just people all milling around. But right over here to the right of the parking lot, I remember seeing this old pickup truck, this big old football player named Stephen, who just lost his dad, sitting on the tailgate, just slumped down looking at the ground. But he was not by himself, because all around him were the guys in my youth group. And they weren't flipping through their Bible trying to find answers for the day. They weren't feeling like they had to defend God. They were just standing there looking at the ground with him. Just loving him like Jesus. The love of her life is drifting away. They're losing the fight for another day. The life that she's known is falling apart. A fatherless home, a child's broken heart. And you're holding her hand, you're straining for words, you're trying to make sense of it all. And she's desperate for hope, darkness clouding her view, and she's looking to you. Just love her like Jesus. Carry her to him. His yoke is easy, his burden is light. You don't need the answers,
To all of life's questions, just know that he loves her. Stay by her side and love her like Jesus. Blessing from heaven would be there soon. Hope fades in the night and blue skies turn gray as the little one slips away. And you're holding their hand, you're straining for words, you're trying to make sense of it all. Jesus, carry them to him. His yoke is easy, his burden is light. You don't need the answers to all of life's questions. Just know that he loves them. Stay by their side and love them like Jesus. Holds our lives in his hands. The God of all the nations holds our lives in his hands. The rock of our salvation holds our lives in his hands. He cares for them just as he cares for you.
Just remind us, there's not one time that they've slipped your mind. You are an awesome, sovereign, holy daddy. You love them more than we do. Father, all we need to do is love them like Jesus. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen. Give the Lord praise.